So in continuation to our previous lecture where we talked about the three phase systems, star and delta connected, so there was one topic that was left out and that was three phase power. So today we'll talk about the three phase power of such systems, and in fact the three phase the three phase power for star and delta connected both comes out to be equal. So we have taken here and we'll try to understand and evaluate power using a star connected system. The same thing can be applied to delta connection as well. So for suppose if you are given a star connected load and the voltages for in each of the phases are given as VAN, so this is the phase voltage, that is the voltage of the terminal A with respect to neutral. So the phase voltage is given as root 2 VP sine omega t. So where VP is the phase voltage, and these are the instantaneous voltage. They are written in small letters. So VAN, this particular voltage is instantaneous voltage. So you can write here as instantaneous. So instantaneous voltage VAN is given as root 2 times the phase voltage, RMS voltage. Since instantaneous are given in terms of maximum voltage, so root 2 VP means VM or the peak voltage. So VM, we used to write instantaneous voltage as VM sine omega t, which means that VAN, the instantaneous voltage, is equal to root 2 VP sine omega t. Likewise VBN, which lags 120 degree from VAN, will be root 2 VP sine omega t minus 120 degrees. And then again VCN that lags by an angle of 240 degree or leads by 120 degree can be written as root 2 VP sine omega t plus 120 degree, or you can write this as root 2 VP sine omega t minus 240 degrees. Now where the power factor root 2 is necessary because VP has been defined as the RMS value. So VP is written in terms of RMS value, and that is why we are multiplying this by root 2 in order to obtain the maximum value. So if suppose that ZY, the star connected load, Z stands for load impedance. So if it is given as Z theta, the phase currents lag behind their corresponding phase voltages by theta. Since we know that I is how much? I is given as V by Z. And since for any reference V, if this angle is taken as 0, let's talk about VAN. So VAN is taken as angle 0, sine omega t. So the angle corresponding to VAN or instantaneous voltage corresponding to terminal A is 0, and that of Z is theta. So I will be having an angle, let's say I comes out to be equal to V by Z, the angle is minus theta, which means that the current will be lagging the voltage by an angle of theta for AN. So this can be written for AN, since we are talking about VAN. Likewise, if you talk about IBN, the current that flows through the terminal B will be written as VBN by Z, and VBN has an angle of minus 120 degree, and thus the current that flows through terminal B will be having an angle of minus 120 minus theta. So we can further write the instantaneous current as given below. So IA can be written as root 2 IP. IP is the RMS value of the phase voltage, sine omega t minus theta. IB can be written as root 2 IP sine omega t minus theta minus 120 degree. Likewise, IC can be written as root 2 IP sine omega t minus theta plus 120 or minus 240 degrees. So is this clear to all? Now if suppose that IP is given as the RMS value of the phase current, the total instantaneous power. So if you talk about the power that flows through the three phase circuit, so we'll start with the instantaneous power, since instantaneous power in each of the phases can be written as VP, the instantaneous voltage, multiplied by instantaneous current, V small and I small. So if, for example, if you are talking about phase A, so the power that flows through, so let me draw the star connected phase loads. So suppose that you have star connected loads. So let's say the voltage that occurs across the terminal, this is N, this is A, let's say this is B, this is C. So the voltage that exists in phase A is VAN. The current that flows through phase A is IAN or IA, simply IA. So the instantaneous power in this particular phase is VAN. We have written this in capital in our previous slide, so let's write this in capital letters. VAN, and the current is IA. So this is the instantaneous power that occurs or exists across load which is connected to terminal A. Likewise, we'll be having an instantaneous power that exists in phase B, which would be instantaneous value of voltage VBN multiplied by IB. Likewise, the power that exists in phase C will be VCN instantaneous multiplied by IC. Do you all agree with this? So the power that now exists in the complete three-phase system, so that would be the sum of all the instantaneous power in the three phases, and that is VA, PA plus PB plus PC. So PA is the instantaneous power that exists in phase A, PB is the instantaneous power existing in phase B, PC is the instantaneous power in phase C, and we have written those instantaneous power expressions as given in the figures. So this can be written as VAN IA plus VBN IB plus VCN IC. Now if you look into the expression, so if you look into the previous slide, we have taken VAN as root 2 VP sin omega t, while IA was taken as root 2 IP sin omega t minus theta. So we are going to multiply these two terms. So what we get is 2 VP IP sin omega t into sin omega t minus theta. This corresponds to PA. Likewise, we'll be getting another expression, 2 VP IP sin omega t minus 120 sin omega t minus theta minus 120 for phase B. And for phase C, we'll be obtaining 2 VP IP sin omega t plus 120 sin omega t minus theta plus 120 degree. And if you're going to take 2 VP IP as common, so you're left with this particular expression. Now we are required to solve this expression. So this has to be done using some mathematics. In fact, trigonometry. So you're supposed to be strong in trigonometric formula in order to solve this. So let us try to solve each of these expressions. Now this can further be, we have expressions like sine omega t minus theta. So if you remember the formula for this, sine, we are going to apply the formula for this as sine A sine B, which is cos A minus B minus cos A plus B divided by 2. So if you evaluate this, so let us write this 2 VP IP. Now we have the first expression is sine omega t. So this can be written as cos omega t minus omega t plus theta. So this is cos A minus B minus cos A plus B omega t plus omega t minus theta will be divided by 2. So this corresponds to phase A. Is that clear? Likewise, for phase B, we are going to write this as cos omega t. Since for phase B, we have sin omega t minus 120 degree and sin omega t minus theta minus 120 degree. So sin A, sin B. So A is omega t minus 120 degrees minus B is omega t plus theta plus 120 degrees. This is cos A minus B. And then we have the next expression as cos A plus B, which can be written as cos omega t minus 120 degrees and plus omega t minus theta minus 120 degrees divided by 2. Then likewise for phase C, so let me write this here. So for phase C we are going to get this again the same expression as plus cos of, since for phase C you can see that it's the value of A is omega t plus 120 or minus 240. Let us take this as omega t minus 240. You can solve this using 120, but I shall be taking this minus 240 because most of the books prefer writing this as sine omega t minus 240 instead of plus 120. So let me write this as omega t minus 240. So I can write this as cos of omega t minus 240 degrees minus omega t plus theta plus 240 degrees, and the next expression is minus cos omega t minus 240 degrees plus omega t minus theta minus 240 degrees divided by 2. So this corresponds to phase C. So is this clear to all? I simply applied the trigonometric rules or the formula that you have been learning. I guess this is clear to all. Okay, now if we further simplify this, so first of all what we see here is 2. So let me move to a clear side. Yes, so we have 2 and 2 in the denominator, so let us cancel this out. So what we are left with is equal to Vp Ip. Now we have cos omega t minus omega t, so first thing is that these cancel out. Then we have this expression with same omega t, and then here we again have an omega t minus 240 plus 240 also cancels. Likewise we have minus 120 and plus 120 cancel out. Okay, so now what we are left with is cos of theta minus cos 2 omega t minus theta, and then we have cos theta, so this the next expression is cos of theta minus cos of 2 omega t minus theta minus 240 degrees. Then here we have again cos of theta minus cos 2 omega t minus 480 plus omega t, minus theta. Is this clear to all? So this can further be written as, so if you people feel any sort of problem while I solve this, so you can ask me. So Vp Ip into 3 cos of theta, we have summed these three expressions, and now what we are left with is cos of 2 omega t minus theta cos of 2 omega t minus theta minus 240 cos of 2 omega t minus theta minus 480 degree. So let us try to evaluate this or simplify this further. So we'll be applying the formula for cos of A minus B in these two cases. So the reason is that we have this angle 2 omega t minus theta common in all 2 omega t minus theta in all the three expressions, and the extra thing that we see in these two is minus 240 and minus 40. So let us consider 2 omega t minus theta as A and 240 as B. So we will be applying the formula of cos A minus B. So let us write this as cos 2 omega t minus theta as it is, and for this cos So the next expression is cos 2 omega t, or since cos of A minus B is cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. So this can be written as minus cos. So you can correct me if you find that I am committing any mistake. Cos 2 omega t minus theta as A. Cos of B is minus 240 degrees. Sorry, not minus, because cos A minus B is cos A cos B minus sin A plus sin A sin B. So cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. Likewise, the next expression for this is minus cos 2 omega t minus theta cos of 480 degrees minus sin 2 omega t minus theta sin 480 degrees. Now if we further simplify this, so cos of 240, so if you're going to use calculator, so use your calculator to evaluate cos of 240 degrees. So in fact, if you remember the values of cos and values of 120, and so this is 90, and then you have 180 somewhere here at minus 1, and this is again 180 plus 60. So we apply cos of sine of 30 or cos of 60. So this comes out to be minus 1 by 2. So cos of 240 is minus 1 by 2. So let me write the value here, minus 1 by 2. Now sine of 240, if you use calculator, this is 180 plus 60. So negative of sine 60. So this is, I guess, minus root 3 by 2. So this should be minus root 3 by 2. Minus root 3 by 2. Cos of 480. So cos of 480, any value that exceeds 360 degree. So you can break this and write this as cos of 360 plus 120. So cos of 360 plus 120 can be written as cos of 120. And cos of 120 is minus 1 by 2. And sine of 480 can be written as sine of 360 plus 120 or sine of 120. So sine of 120 can be written as plus root 3 by 2. So I guess this is clear to all. So this is how we try to break the expression in order to simplify problem. So since we saw that there are expressions, numerical values like 240, 480, and that is why we separated them out. So you could have done like, you could have considered A as 2 omega t and B as theta minus 240, but that would have complicated the problem instead of solving. So we have considered B only the numerical values like 240 and 480. So now if we further simplify this, so this can be written as Vp Ip 3 cos theta minus cos of 2 omega t minus theta and minus cos of 2 omega t minus theta into half, minus half. So this can be written as plus cos of 2 omega t minus theta divided by 2. Then we have sine 2 omega t. 240 was minus root 3 by 2 and 480 is plus root 3 by 2. while these values are same. So you have negative, negative, positive, and then we have positive, negative, negative. So these expression cancel out. And the next expression you're left with is minus cos 2 omega t. Cos of 480 is minus half. So this can be written as plus cos 2 omega t minus theta divided by 2. So I guess this is clear to all. Theek hai. So now in this expression we see that cos 2 omega t, we are left with cos 2 omega t minus theta, and we have here half cos 2 omega t minus theta, and these two add up to give you plus cos 2 omega t minus theta. Isko likh hi lete hain. So power, that the instantaneous power comes out to be equal to 3 Vp Ip cos theta minus cos 2 omega t minus theta plus cos 2 omega t minus theta. So this cancel out. So what you're left with is 3 Vp Ip cos of theta. So this is the power for the complete power for three phase circuit. And the similar expression can be obtained for delta connected loads. So I leave this on you.